Good morning. This video is the continuation of the previous one. And after watching that, you might have noticed that there is one problem when we assemble this particular assembly is okay, but the functionality. Say if we want to adjust this distance, here, if we fix a pin here, this particular item will not move. So I want to modify the assembly in such a way that this particular block is in that V support is in contact with this right handle, and also it should move forward or backward. So how to edit that? That is the thing which I'm going to explain to you right now. So you will have this model with you. If you have watched my previous video and created this model, so how to edit this? So that is what I'm going to explain now. So let us first go here, V support. So this we will activate. Then we will check this this sketch here. So this particular this dia 3 circle, what I am going to do is I am going to delete this horizontal vertical constraint. So just give me a second. So turn off this horizontal vertical I'm going to delete. So I want to have a modified dimension in this way, such that I will modify the right handle also. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to add one dimension, that is, so this was earlier at the center and the shaft diameter was dia 6, right? The shaft diameter was dia 6. So I want to modify this slot something. It should come here, and instead of this hole I want to make it a groove. So how much it should be? So this is so from here to here it will come 3. So I will make this as 3.5. so 1 mm it will go inside, 3.5. okay, so what I'm going to do is I'm going to give this dimension as this is 3.5. let me check how much it is coming. Finish sketch. So turn on the body. Turn on the body here. So let us activate this assembly and check where this hole. Okay, I think that hole is okay now. Now if we make a groove here, it will automatically be okay. Okay, so I think we will edit this sketch also. Edit this sketch. There is some error is there. Okay, finish sketch. So extrude, we will edit the extrude. Edit feature. Okay, we have to see what is happening here. Which is the feature? Right side handle. So let me activate this and find out what went wrong. So edit feature here. Then we will okay. Then okay. So now you can see that it is done. So now okay, we will activate the main assembly now. So now you can see that this particular item is okay. What happened to my lock pin? Okay. Oh, I think the lock pin is here. So what we will do is we will edit the lock pin. Okay, what we will do is we will remove the assembly constraint and we will assemble once again. Okay, let us go here where it is. So this we have to find out. So let me delete this, all these things, joints I'm going to delete. Let me delete this also, delete. So delete all these joints. Then again I'm going to do what is assembled as built joint. So let me make the joint. Okay, for the time being I'm going to add as built joint. Then okay, then assemble as built joint. So this and this. Okay, assemble as built joint. So this as well as this. Okay, now so let me turn off this support here now. So let me this move somewhere here. Okay, then so this time assemble joint. So it will ask some components have been moved, so I'm going to capture position because I want to select for my assembly. Now what I'm going to do is I'm going to select this center point here. So come here, select the center point, then at this circle center I'm going to align, then okay. So done. So joints I can turn off, I don't want to see any joints visible. Now as I told you, so I want to make a groove for this, then only this will this can be able to move through this particular slot. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to select this right side handle, then activate the component here. Then what I'm going to do is I'm going to select a plane, say that is, say I'm going to select XY plane, right click, create sketch. Right here what I'm going to do is I'm going to project this curve with a so just project, press P and select the circle, then okay. Then draw a axis also, just to draw a line. Draw a line here. This is my axis. Then select this and press X. Finish sketch. So now what we will do is we will right click. So we will right click, isolate this. Now what we are going to do is we are going to revolve this. Revolve, then axis, this axis, then okay. Oh, it's too much. No, it is okay. Now we can activate. So this we will unisolate here. Activate the main assembly here. So now you can notice one thing, that this pin always remain in contact with this block and this can be rotated so that this position can be moved forward and backward. So this is the thing I want to explain to you by using so if we have done any mistake, so no need to modify many things. Directly you will be able to make the modification by simply editing some of the sketches. You might have noticed when I have done the changes for this circle, remaining all details get updated. Only thing was, there was one error was shown for the extrude. When I selected that particular sketch, automatically it got corrected. Okay, so I hope you understood what was my concern. So what I have done is, I have modified this this particular area here. This circle, instead of this circle, I changed a changed this portion as a groove. And when I fix this particular block at this location where this particular item is going inside here, then my eye hole will come here. And this groove, this is a groove, this groove is like this. Okay, so this is the groove here. So when I make this particular item, automatically this particular handle will be always in contact with the V support. And because of the pin, this pin which is fixed to this block, and this can be rotated without any problem because this is a groove. So this can move in this direction or in this direction. So this correction I want to highlight you. So that is why I made this video once again. So thanks for watching and thank you.